everyone, welcome back to Fire Emblem Heroes. So today we have Legendary Seraphine Fast Focus for the showcase, a somewhat cool way to follow up to the Resplendent Julia showcase. And he's also a really good unit. We saw him into his gacha a long time ago. We never managed to pull him in that gacha, but we did indeed pull him in the Blumaria gacha. So I'm really happy to bring you the showcase. While I will do the build discussion, I just wanted to give you a warning because I only managed to do one build. The second build is an idea that I had, but I didn't have any of the tool to make it realistic, so I didn't attempt to complete it. However, we still have the two gameplay showcases with the base and the other build that I made, so hopefully you guys appreciate it. The build that I made is actually premium because I pulled a Sed before the gacha for Plumeria, so Sed was actually a premium fodder for Seraph since he gave him a time pulse, but we'll check more about that later. So this Seraph is from the end of a genealogy, if I had to guess. He wears somewhat of a look closer to his father Sigurd, and he's actually a really good unit in the game as well. I got him with also a really good stat spread, so hopefully you look forward to the build showcase to check that out. As usual guys, the showcase will feature dialogue, will feature art, will feature the build discussion at the end of the gameplay showcase. This is a limited unit, this is a legendary unit, so it doesn't always come out of the gacha. You have to check out the gachas at the end of the month. If your favorite legendary or mythical unit is featured in them, then you could hope to pull for them. Right now, Seraph is still in the Plumeria gacha, so if you want to try and get him, go for it, I guess. For us, we will check each other later in the build discussion. For now, I will leave you to the dialogue and the art showcase. Later. Ok, so here's Seraph, and now we will check out his base skill set and of course his stats. You can already tell that there is something very weird going on with this attack. It is because it is an asset. 61 is really really high for a unit. Of course, it is because of the asset, otherwise it will probably be a little bit lower. I think he has a super boon in attack, which is actually really nice because this is best boon. I got the flow in dress, which isn't the best because you want him to be a tank for mages and for melee, so it is what it is. Other than that, we have a 41 attack average on the little high side, attack 61, amazing, high, very high. The speed is 17, low, but thanks to Holy War's End it doesn't really matter. Death 37, average on the high side, or maybe high, I'll say high, not very high, but high. Res average on the low side because of the flow, so we'll have to do some compensation with the seal to fix this flow in the res. So let's check out his base skill set. We have Virtuous Tearfing, grants res plus 3 if foe initiates combat or if Seraph HP is lower than 100% at start of combat, you inflict attack and death minus 6 on foe during combat. And if you deal damage to foe during combat, you restore 7 HP to unit. So, difficult effect to trigger in player phase, easy effect to trigger in enemy phase, mostly because of his skill set. Not much else to say here. This weapon is amazing if you manage to trigger it, but don't try to do it in player phase because the requirements are actually very hard. You still need to get attacked, which means that you still need to do a successful enemy base. That's why I don't really believe on a player build for Selic, but I would go wrong. I will try to give you my idea of a player face build later, but I didn't have really any tool to make it worthwhile, honestly. For special, we have Ignis, makes sense because of his death, but I prefer a healing special like Noontime or Sol, depending on the cooldown that you prefer. Maybe Sol is better with other requirements, but I like Noontime better. Distant Counter, a premium ability, maybe better than Distant Foil, since you have such an high defense that mages and dagger units will do anything to you. Then we have the most interesting skill of the set, which is Desperation 3 under a new name, Holy War's End. If unit HP is higher than 50% and Foe initiates combat, unit makes a guaranteed follow-up attack before Foe can make a follow-up attack. So, with 17 speed, Selic needs some way to deal damage on the enemy face. And that is what Holy War's End is for, because the enemy attack, Selic attacks back twice, and most of the time the enemy will die. So you can see the potential in enemy face for Selic just by this skill alone. Then we have Joint on Death, which raises defense for both you and your allies, and Mirror Stance 2 because, of course, as I said earlier, to fix my very low res. Overall, the base skill set for Selic is enough to have a very solid unit from the get-go. You don't really need to modify anything because the seal will do most of the fixing for the stats, and the skills, all of them work really well. Maybe the only thing that you could replace is the special, but special abilities right now aren't really that limited apart from the die, which is new. Ok, so let's move on to my optimal build, or rather the Divine Tank build for Selic. Here I tried to adjust at best his skill to make the perfect build for Selic in all circumstances. So we have Noontime. As I said earlier, a way to fix the fact that he needs some healing since he's an enemy face tank. Pulse Smoke 3. This is amazing because it delays your enemy specials, which makes Selic life a little bit easier. And is also, in general, one of the best C skills for any enemy face tank. And then Mirror Stance 2 again to buff, of course, his resistance, which is a little bit flawed. Now, is this or this one better? I feel like Divine Tank is way better, if you can afford it. Pulse Smoke 3 is a premium skill that I got from Sed, which I pulled a little bit ago, and I recommend trying it out. We'll see it later in the gameplay showcase, since it really works well with the Selic skill set. Selic is meant to be both a defense and a rest tank, if you can do it, but specials are always a bane in any tank side, because they can do amazing damage, even though you have such high defenses. So, hopefully later we will see how well it works. Now, the player face build. As you can see, I had no abilities at all to give it, so I will break them. Zombie, you have Lul Attack Res, or Lul Attack Defense, depending on which role you want to give yourself on the attack side. I'd say Lul Attack Def probably is better in this case, so Lul AD. On DA, I suggest Brazen Attack Def, or attacks rest, depending on what you want to do, so we put Braids at D. On the C, Joint on Attack probably is the best, or a solo skill, for example, Attack and Death solo. So this is a very Attack Death oriented build. It makes sense since Selic has such high defense, and you get the whole idea right here. Does this work well? The discussion right here is hard to tell, because Selic isn't meant for player face at all. It's not meant to be a player face character. Why? He has 17 defense. You remove the enemy face ability that he has, which is the Holy War's End. Selic cannot tank anymore hits in enemy face, because he will get attack per 4, 2 attacks in the first attack of the enemy and 2 other attacks after he counter attacks. That are enough to kill him. He won't be able to take a hit. So that's why I don't really think a player face builds for Legendary Selic are worthy. But I could be wrong, of course. You guys, let me know in the comments if you have a Legendary Selic with a solid player face build, and I will try my best to copy it and see for myself if it is worth it. Personally, I say that we will use the divine tech and the base skill set for the gameplay showcase, which is coming right after this section. Anyway, hopefully you guys enjoyed this little small look at Legendary Seraph. Of course, Legendary unit, as you know, have really tight builds to work with, so you don't really need to replace much, but I wanted to show you guys this character anyway. The next showcase will come after the Halloween event, which is coming on Monday or Tuesday, right now I don't really remember. We will try to pull on that banner. I do have up to 50 orbs right now, so it shouldn't be a problem when we get there. And hopefully we also get the duo character that comes out of the banner. So, this is Hunter Lodge. Remember to leave a like and a sub if you like the showcase. Remember also to leave in the comments any builds or suggestions that you have for Legendary Seraph for me or for the other players. I always appreciate if you do. And hopefully, I will see you next time on the next showcase. Remember, right now, we head into the gameplay showcase for Seraph, showing you the two builds that I made for him. So, enjoy the gameplay showcase and see you in the next showcase for my build discussion. Bye!
I'll do all I can.
Oh, what? Do I have to?
Let's deliver. No more losses! I'll bear this legacy. Hit!
I understand. If I must!
Which to choose?
Let's try that. No more losses.
I'm ready.
I'll bear this legacy.
If I must.
I understand.
Sure thing.
The world made new! Hit! I bear the light! I'll do all I can.
I have to.
Which to choose?
What?
Press on. No regrets. Let's try that.
You insist?
Let's deliver.
I understand.
No more losses.